Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, we are going to talk about the next phylum, that is Ctenophora. So as like we do in all the videos, we are going to talk about the peculiar feature in the very first step. सबसे पहले उस feature की बात करेंगे जो सिर्फ इसी phylum में पाया जाता है. So the Ctenophoras are also known as sea walnuts or comb jellies. So इनके दूसरे नाम हैं sea walnut and comb jellies, right? And comb jelly too contains a word that is comb, which reflects the peculiar feature. क्योंकि नाम में ही कुछ ना कुछ था. अगर आप Coelenterata का देखें या Cnidaria का देखें, so from the word Cnidaria, there is nidocytes or nidoblast. In Porifera, from the word pore, there is ostia and osculum, that is the water canal system. So the name indicates the most peculiar feature on its own. So the Ctenophora are known as the sea walnuts or comb jellies. And why comb jellies? Because they contain 8 external rows of ciliated comb plates. What does this particular sentence mean? Unki body par 8 rows, okay, you know very well about rows and columns. So there will be 8 rows of comb plates. There are plate like structure which are ciliated, okay, cilia are present on that. And if there are 8 different rows, this word is very important here. You have to memorize the number, that is 8. So 8 external rows, since they are present on the external body surface, they are ciliated. And why ciliated? Because the cilia helps the Ctenophora in locomotion. Right? So since these 8 plates are ciliated, they contain cilia, so this cilia will whip, okay, cilia will move to provide the locomotion. This is the peculiar feature. So from the word comb jellies, you can learn a particular character, that is ciliated comb plates, which are 8 in number, that are present on the external side, aur wo kya karte hain, locomotion provide karte hain Ctenophora ko. After that, there are some characters which we know very well. Okay, we don't need to do anything. It is having tissue level of organization. The Porifera has cellular level of organization, cell aggregated plan. After that, the Ctenophora, right? The Coelenterata is having tissue level, and the Ctenophora is also having tissue level plan. Okay, after that, radially symmetrical. We know very well that there are only 3 phylums which has radially symmetrical organisms. The first one is Coelenterata. The second one is Ctenophora, and the third one is adult echinoderms, which is an exception. So it is radially symmetrical. Now diploblastic. Platyhelminthes and all the higher animals are triploblastic, that is they contain 3 germ layers, ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. But the Porifera, Coelenterata and Ctenophora will only be having 2 germ layers, that is ectoderm and endoderm, and in between that there is an undifferentiated cell layer known as mesoglia. That's why they are having only 2 germ layers. It is known as diploblastic. After that, they are exclusively marine. I have put this particular word into box. Why? Because exclusively word means without exception. It means that all the individuals of Ctenophora are marine without any exception. So I have already made a video on the exclusively marine animals, so you can watch it down. वहाँ पर कुछ ऐसे organisms की बात की गई है, कुछ ऐसी phylums की जिसके सारे individuals सिर्फ marine ही हैं. और इस पे question आता भी है. It can be directly asked. You must be given the name of 4 phylums and you have to select odd one out on the basis of their habitat. So you must be separating Ctenophora as it is exclusively marine. And in some cases, there are 3 different phylums which are exclusively marine. So you must have to select the rest one. Tino ke alawa jo chauthi phylum hai, wo aapko wahan pe pakadni hogi. So this question is already asked in the past year papers. You can have a look. But this is very important. So we have to note words like this. Okay, most, all, none, exclusively, and only. Only also does not contain no exception. Let's talk about this. So they are exclusively marine. It simply means that all the individuals of Ctenophora are marine. Wo marine water mein hi paaye jaate hain. After that, some other things such as digestion. So in the very first phylum, we have talked about intracellular digestion. Then in Coelenterata, intra and extracellular. In Ctenophora, it is also extra and intracellular. So you don't have to worry about this. You just have to memorize ki inka matlab kya hota hai. I am going to give you a trick in the next upcoming videos by which you can easily memorize all the examples, whether it is extracellular or intracellular, right? So extra simply means outside the cell, as the name indicates. Intra simply means inside the cell. So if the digestion takes place inside the cell, it is intracellular, and if it is taking outside the cell, then it is extracellular. After that, bioluminescence. It is a very important property and it is usually asked in the examination. Bioluminescence simply means when bio, that is living organisms, used to provide light, that is luminescence. So jab koi living organism light emit karta hai, that particular feature is known as bioluminescence, and it is very abundant in Ctenophora. So Ctenophora aap jab dekhenge to aapko light emitting organisms milenge inme kafi sare. So this is also a very important feature. Now sexes are not separate. It means that there is no male, there is no female. In a single individual, there is male gamete and female gamete also. It means that they are usually bisexual. Male or female, same individual mein. So baaton ko ghuma ke kaha gaya hai. That's why NCRT is a little bit more complex. Sexes are not separate. It means that there is no individual male, there is no individual female. A single individual is containing both male reproductive organs and female reproductive organs. Okay, we will talk about higher organisms. In this case, there are no organs, so we will be talking about sex cells. Okay, क्योंकि यहाँ पर organs, organ level organization अभी आई नहीं है, there is tissue level organization. So we cannot say organ, right? So इसीलिए जानबूझकर इस तरीके की स्टेटमेंट मैंने यूज की कि आपको अगर assertion reason में organ बोल दिया जाए तो आपको उसको गलत मार्क करना है, because there is no organ, right? We are talking about Ctenophora, it does not contain any organ, it is tissue level organization system, right? ये अभी organ में तब्दील नहीं हुआ है. So they are bisexual, कहने का ये मतलब है बहुत सिंपल भाषा में कि मेल और फीमेल सेक्स सेल्स जो होंगे एक इंडिविजुअल में पाए जाए. After that, only sexual reproduction is found. This is very important statement. That's why I have put it in a box. Only sexual reproduction is found. And during that sexual reproduction, the fertilization is external. Now, I have already provided a trick for that. External fertilization. CC, hemas, eco. C simply means Coelenterata. C simply means Ctenophora. Hema simply means hemichordata. And eco simply means echinodermata. So in all four these, all these non-chordates, these four phylums will be having external fertilization. हमारे पास ट्रिक है, हमने लगा दी ट्रिक, सी से हमें एक फाइलम मिली और हमने लिख दिया एक्सटर्नल, दैट्स इट. एंड द डेवलपमेंट इज इनडायरेक्ट. इट मींस दैट द जायगोट इज नॉट गेटिंग डायरेक्टली डेवलप्ड इनटू न्यू ऑर्गेनिज्म, इट इज गोइंग थ्रू सम लार्वल स्टेज. अगर वो डायरेक्ट होता तो वो डायरेक्ट इंडिविजुअल बन जाता, मैच्योर हो जाता, बट इट इज गोइंग थ्रू सम लार्वल स्टेज, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज इनडायरेक्ट, राइट? सो व्हाट आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट things from this article which may be asked in the examination. Tissue level you know very well, radial asymmetrical you know, diploblastic you know, these are exclusively marine, very important point. What is the peculiar feature? 8 external rows of ciliated comb plates, that's why these are known as comb jellies. The third important thing is they are bioluminescent, they can emit light. After that, only sexual reproduction is found. उसके अलावा कोई इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इसमें नहीं है, क्योंकि बाकी सारी चीजें कैरेक्टर्स आपके दिमाग में धीरे धीरे घुस जाएंगे. जैसे ही आप लोग वीडियोस देखते रहेंगे, जैसे आपको ट्रिक्स मिलती रहेंगी, आपको कुछ और नहीं करना. यू जस्ट हैव टू मेमोराइज द पेक्यूलियर फीचर. यार इसमें ऐसी क्या खास बात है कि इसको अलग रखा गया? ओके, सिर्फ हमें वो पेक्यूलियर फीचर, वो खास बात जाननी है हर फाइलम के बारे में, राइट? जैसे वो वाटर वास्कुलर सिस्टम भी हम पढ़ेंगे इकाइनोडर्म्स में. That is the peculiar feature of echinoderms. In chordates, there is notochord, nerve cord, postanal tail, pharyngeal gill slits. There are different kind of characters which are peculiar or which are characteristic features of each and every phylum. Uske baare mein hame detail mein baat karni hai. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. If you got the video very well, then please hit like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel and keep supporting.